Man, fuck these niggas.
Tunchi's back. Tunchi's back. As all these bitches screaming that Tunchi's back. All eyes on me. Nigga, picture I'm rolling. Strapped up with that mat. Messed up like a goalie. Man, my bitch on that coke. She snorted four in the baby. Not a bitch on me. She selling pussy and pay me. They saying Tunchi's back. Tunchi's back. And I bought them twins with me. Nigga, click and clack. Let's go. Out on.
Okay guys, what's up? Before I start this video out, look at what the opponent has the lead. He has a Weavile. I have a Thunderous. Last game he had a Latios lead, and then I'm like, same leads, dude, because we disconnected. And he just like, okay, and then starts without with the fucking Weavile. So before this battle even started, he has negative respect points. But without further ado, let's get into the battle right now. So, obviously, this guy is not cool for starting out with the Weavile, knowing I started out with the Thunderous, but whatever. I thought he would overpredict, but then again, it's his first turn, so I'm just going to go into my mag, got swag. This is Magneton, got mad swag. And just going to go for the Ice Punch, just going to do a decent amount. I'm thinking he might be Bandit or Choice, but whatever. I'm going to predict his Ferrothorn switch, because I'm this motherfucking beast. And I'm going to go into my Evile, my Cable guy, and he's going to protect us because it's a safe move on his part, and I'm also going to predict this switch, and I'm going to switch into my Tupac back, and guess what he's going to switch into? He's going to switch into his Dragonite. That was just beast that I'm able to predict all these switches, and I go for the HP Ice, even though he has multi-scale, it's going to do almost half, and he's going to go straight for the Outrage, but don't worry, I got a Sash, so I'm going to bring me down my Sash. Then I'm going to hit him back with that HP Ice, and it's going to take him out. So, already, it's 6-5, I think. Whatever. He's going to go into his Ferrothorn. I'm thinking, you know, he probably wants to set up rocks right now. I'm just going to hit you with that Focus Blast. So, it was kind of a big surprise. I don't know. I think it was a big surprise for him, and he's going to set up his Stealth Rocks. Thinking it might switch out or something. I don't know. But anyway, and with this Focus Blast, and right here I make a good move, and I go for the HP Ice just in case he switches out, and he's protects himself, and he's gonna predict for me to use the same move again, and I just go for the Focus Blast and take your ass out of here. So yeah, that's two Pokemon down on the other side, and right now I make a pretty bad move because I know this dude is Choice in some sort of way, and I switch out. That was terrible. Because they had Stealth Rocks up anyway. I could have used it as fodder, but I should have just let it die so I knew what move it logged itself into. And it goes for Brick Break. And that sucks because it's even a 2-hit KO. And I could have taken out with Flash Cannon, even if he had Brick, even if it was locked into Brick Break. So that just sucks. Big fucking dick. And I go into my Evire, and unfortunately, I do not have Cross Chop, but I do have the Fire Punch. And that's the best move I have against this Weavile. And look, guess what happens? Doesn't motherfucking die. I don't have any priority moves on this team, and I want to use that guy for later, so I have to switch out. I go into my Zapdos, and it's able to take that Brick Break like a motherfucking champ, and this guy is pretty bulky, so I have agility because I don't have any speed investment at all, so I just go for the agility right here, and I believe I roost. I don't know what I do. I'm just gonna switch out because I'm fearing height, H pump, and stuff like that. Oh no, I was fearing the trick. I was a motherfucking beast. I predicted the trick, so I go into my Galvantula, and you need to fear me because I have a Choice Scarf. I can outspeed your entire team. Probably not that Weavile because that Weavile is obviously Choice. But yeah, I'm gonna hit you with that Thunder. You're gonna get paralyzed. And but yeah, I did give him my Life Orb, which is kind of bad because Rotom with Hydro Pump and Life Orb is not playing games. So I'm going to go into my Zapdos again. So I'm just going to go for Roost, knowing that I'll be faster. And right now he gets Parahax. And right now I make another bad move and I go for Agility. It was like, this is a terrible move because he's going to just send in his Weavile right after I do this. This was really bad move on my part. And he goes for the H Pump. And that does a shit ton. I have a lot of special defensive investment, and that still did like a shitload. So I just go for the Thunderbolt, which I should have done last turn. So that's just gonna fuck me over even more at the end. So And I was sending out his weave out, and right now it's a big game. I'm thinking, will I be faster? Will I be faster? I just switch out just to be safe, because weave out is a fast ass motherfucker, even without the scarf. Then he's gonna show that he has ice shard. So goddamn, that would have definitely taken me out. So smart move going to my Wiz Khalifa. If you're wondering why I have this Rotom, it's because it's the most defensive electric Pokemon out there. Most of electric Pokemon are only specially bulky, but this one is specially and defensively bulky. So, I go for the Light Screen, knowing that he only had specially offensive Pokemon, and now I go for the Woolworths because I have no fucking attacks. Yes, no fucking attacks on the Rotom. What the fuck is this madness? So yeah, dual screen Rotom with Woolwisp and Toxic, it's not the best. It's like terrible. I make a terrible switch, and I go into my Zapdos. I should have switched into my Thunderous at this point, but it was a fucking misclick. It was so bad. That was just another terrible move, because I probably could have survived one hit, go for the roost. I don't know. Anyway, I go into my Evi, thinking an Ice Punch could take it out, because I'm choice and I'm mocked into it, but it doesn't takes it like a motherfucker. Like, goddamn, Gengar took it really well, so... I mean, I didn't want to lock myself in a Thunder Punch, but then I could have switched out and switched back in. So, I don't know if that was the smartest part again. So, yeah, obviously made a few bad plays. And, obviously, I'm going to go for the Woolworths because they have no fucking attack. So, yeah. So, he is going to... That Gengar's going to die. So, I was able to take out four of his Pokemon, which I think is pretty damn decent considering he has a OU Horde team and I just have a Monotype Electric. So, that is going to be the game because he's going to take out my whole team basically by that Weavile and that Brick Break on the Magnet swag really fucked me over. But whatever, guys. Hope you guys enjoyed my Monotype Electric. I have a special video coming out on Thursday. Sorry for uploading this on Wednesday morning. But whatever. This is PM, the one and only. Deuces.